Hello. Well, I worked for many years ago. It's not so new trend, but on this kind of interior point or feasible points algorithm for nonlinear optimization. I consider the nonlinear constraint optimization problem defined here. And with inequality and inequality constraints. In this case, the function and all the constraints are smooth functions, not necessarily convex. Then I present a general approach for interior point algorithm, interior and feasible points algorithm to solve the nonlinear constraint optimization problem. Given an initial estimate of x of at the interior of the inequality constraints, this algorithm defines a sequence of interior points with the objective reduced at each iteration. And by these techniques, we can obtain first order quasi-Newton or Newton algorithms. Then, first I shall describe a feasible direction algorithm. This algorithm at each point defined a feasible descent direction and an accurate line search is done in order to find a point with lower objective feasible. Okay, then I shall describe the feasible, the FIPA, the feasible arc interior point algorithm. The line search is done along an arc. In the case of FIPA, we can prove in a very strong way for the quasi-Newton method, we can prove two-step superlinear convergence. These algorithms are very simple to code, strong and efficient. It does not involve penalty functions, active strategies, quadratic programming, subproblems. With this algorithm, we need simply to solve two linear systems at each iteration and then make a line search. Since we need to solve linear systems, we can apply many kind of techniques to solve linear system more efficiently depending on the structure of the linear system. Here I mentioned we need an interior point at the interior of the inequality constraints. When the problem has only inequality constraint, the objective function is reduced at each iteration. When we have also equality constraints, there is a function that is reduced at each iteration. It's like a penalty function. I shall describe the case when we have only inequality constraints. This is the problem. Okay. And I shall give some definitions. First, we say that D is a descent direction at a point x when the directional derivative of x is negative. That is, we can walk along the direction d a certain step tau, reducing the function. A feasible direction is when we have at a feasible point, and we have a direction along this feasible point, and we can walk along this direction, remaining feasible, a certain distance t. When we have a vector field, ¿me escuchan? When we have a vector field, we say that it is a uniformly feasible directions field if there exists a step length tau positive such that x plus td is in equal for is in omega is feasible for all t between 0 and tau and for all x in omega. That is, here we said that the feasible step was tau theta of x, and here we say that there is a theta of x has a lower bound, a positive, a strictly positive lower bound. Well, in this method, to compute a feasible descent direction, we compute first a feasible direction, this direction d0, then we compute a restoring direction d1 that restores feasibility, and to have a feasible descent direction, we make an appropriate combination between these two directions. Okay? Here we took as an example the case when where we are in the boundary, that is the more critical region to points to have a feasible point. And here I shall show first the algorithm to show that it's very simple. We have some parameters, but this method is practically doesn't depend of tanning parameters. Then we have these two linear systems of equations. The first linear system gives me the descent direction. The second linear system gives me the restoring direction. And here, the matrix of the system, here we have the quasi-Newton matrix in the case of quasi-Newton method. Here we have the Jacobian matrix of the constraints, also here, and this is a diagonal matrix with the constraint. Then you can see we only solve these two systems of equations. Then we compute a parameter, we compute a number rho with this condition, and then the search direction is d0 plus rho d1, and then d is a feasible descent direction, okay? And we make a line search. Here we present a kind of Armijo line search, and in the line search we want to find a new step with a decrease on the of the function and feasible. Well, here we have, I shall explain now how we arrived to this formulation, okay? Here we have Karosh-Kontogger optimality condition for the inequality constraint problem. And here is the gradient of the Lagrangian equals zero. Here we have the complementarity conditions where G is a diagonal matrix with the constraints in the diagonal. And here we have the inequalities conditions on G and lambda. Okay. Then, we make some assumptions about all the equations, all the function and the constraint and smooth. The function F and G are continuously differentiable in omega, under derivative satisfies Lipschitz condition. And what is important here, we have a regularity condition, that is, all the vectors given by the gradient of the constraints at the solution must constitute a linearly independent set of vectors. Then there is the regularity condition that we need, but only in the solution point. Okay. Then, well, what happens? We have a system here that we want to solve with equations and inequations. The idea is, okay, let us consider the equations, and we shall try to solve this linear system of equations. The unknown are x and lambda, the Lagrange multipliers, and in such a way that all the iterates verifies the inequations. So that is, all the iterates are feasible, and all the iterates have in lambda have lambda positive. Okay, and then to do that, well, we shall solve this system. Here we have the Jacobian matrix of this system, and a Newton iteration for solving this system is given here, okay, where x is the present point and x zero, x lambda is the present iterate, and x zero, lambda zero, is the new estimate. And lambda is a diagonal matrix with lambda e in the diagonal. Then we can, this iterate, we can make a Newton iterate, putting here the Hessian of the Lagrangian, or we can put a quasi-Newton approach, or even we can put a first identity matrix, and with that we have a first order method. Then if we define the zero in this way, we have this system of equation, and this system of equations give me d zero and an estimative of lambda zero. Then we proved that if base definite positive, lambda positive, g less or equal zero, that is, the constraints are verified, then the system has a unique solution, and d zero is a descent direction. Okay. However, d zero is not always a feasible direction, as we saw in the drawing before, where we are on the boundary of the feasible region. D zero is tangent to the feasible region. Then, depending on the curvature, he can be unfeasible. D zero. And here we show we have these equations. This was this equation, okay. And here we have this equation is the same. No, here we have this equation is the same, and writing it equation by equation, we have this equation for each constraint, and we can see that when gi is equal to zero, then d zero is orthogonal to the gradient of ga. Then d zero is tangent. That's why d zero is not always a feasible direction. Then, to have a feasible direction, we add a number. In the here, we have a number in the left side of the second equation. Then, when g is zero, here if g is zero, this product is negative. then the GD enters on the feasible region. Okay? Then the negative number in the right-hand side produces the effect of bending the zero to the interior of the feasible region, being the definition relative, being the deflection relative to each constraint proportional to rho. As the diffraction is proportional to rho and the zero is decent, by establishing upper bounds on rho, it is possible to ensure that there is a decent feasible direction. Then we want to impose this condition, that is, d0 gradient f is negative since d0 is a decent direction. Then if d verifies this condition, d is also, d transpose gradient f is also negative. That implies that d is also a feasible direction. To compute rho, we split the linear system. We split this linear system in these two. Then we solve these two linear systems, and we have a solution of and then to have D, we have this expression that depends of rho, that is the deflection parameter, and then we compute exactly. We have not need to make any estimate of parameters. We compute D parameters rho in order to obtain a feasible decent direction. And here I have again this representation. Then in fact the feasible the search direction is a uniformly feasible directions field. To find a new primal point, an accurate light search is done in the direction of D, and we look for a new point with feasible and with a lower function. And we can employ different updating rules to define a new lambda positive. Then this is an extension of Armijo search. In this extension, we have that the function must be lower at the new point than at the old point. This is Armijo's search for unconstrained optimization. And here we have that if lambda is positive, the new constraint must be negative, feasible, but if lambda is negative, we don't allow with this condition, we don't allow GI to approach the boundary of this constraint in the line search. Then these conditions ensures a reasonable decrease of the function, except only interior points, and this one avoids saturation of non-active constraints. In practice, we employ more efficient some line search procedure. An extension of Wolf's rule combined with interpolation of the functions, an extension of Goldstein rule combined with interpolation of the functions also. Well, we have strong theoretical results of this method. We first proved that the algorithm never fails, in particular that the linear system has always a solution. We prove that any sequence given by the algorithm converges to a Karus Kontukar point for any way of updating and verifying the assumptions above. And we prove that global convergence to a Karus Kontukar point. Global convergence implies that for any initial feasible point, we have convergence to a Karus Kontukar point. Well, we also prove that if we can have a step length equal to 1 near the solution, we have two-step superlinear convergence to the Karus Kontukar point. However, what happens? In examples where the constraints are highly nonlinear, we can have that the step length equal 1 is never obtained. Then, to avoid that, we present the feasible arc algorithm. Here I explain this one. This effect is similar to Marato's effect that happens in successive quadratic programming methods. Well, then we shall make a line search. The line search was first presented by Main and Pollack, then Panier and Titz employed in a feasible SQP algorithm. Then Panier, Titz, and Herskovitz modified FDIPA by including an arc search. All this method requires to solve an additional quadratic programming problem. But here in our approach, we don't need to solve a quadratic programming problem, but only a third linear system with the same matrix. Okay? To compute the arc, we compute the search direction of the feasible direction algorithm, and we compute W tilde, that is like an approximation or like an estimate of the second derivative of the constraints in direction D. It's easy to see that. And then we compute a search system. This is the search system where we compute the tilde. Then the tilde is a search direction that compensates the curvature of the nonlinear constraint. Then the arc is defined in this way. When t equals 0, we are in xk. When t equals 1, we are in xk plus d plus d tilde. And here we have the feasible arc. Then we compute first. Here we have d0, the descent direction, d1, the restoring direction, and here this is d tilde, and our arc comes from here, is tangent to d0, and arrives to d plus d tilde. Okay? And then we make a line search along this arc. We prove that we obtain the step equal to 1 near the solution. Then we prove in a more stronger way two-step superlinear convergence for quasi-Newton method. Okay, and here we have the arc. We compute this is the same that with FDIPA, we compute this direction, then we compute rho, we compute D, we compute W tilde, and then we solve this linear system, and here we have now the Armijo line search, but along the arc, okay? Then this is, I want to show now you some applications, but very, very fast. This is a work with my colleagues, Alfredo Canelas from Uruguay, and Jean Roche from the Nancy University in France. Our problem is the electromagnetic shaping of liquid metal. We have a liquid metal. We have an electrical and electromagnetic field, and the electromagnetic field, it gives a shape to the liquid metal. Then, this is an example with mercury, and here we have the formulation for the problem in 2D. And then here we have four electrical wires, and this is the shape obtained of the metal. Well, here we have the variational model of the direct problem, but we want to solve an inverse problem in this sense, that we want to know we need to put the electrical wires in order to obtain a desired shape. Then this is, then we have some, we minimize some function that gives me the distance between the target shape and this set of admissible domains. And we have two formulations. In one formulation, here we have V, we have the new shape, and we want to minimize V square under the constraints, the physical constraints. And here we work with a slack variable P that when the system is in equilibrium, P is zero. Then we want to minimize P. And here we have an example. This is the desired shape, and these are four wires, okay? And well, what we want is to find the position of the wires and the intensity, electrical intensity of the wires in order to get this shape. And here we have the final position of the wires. Here is the iterative process. You can see that we make less than 30 iterations. And here we have another example. This is the target shape. These are the initial position of the wires. And here we have the optimal distribution of the wires for formulation one and formulation two. Okay, and here we have the iterates. What happened now? There is some problem. Okay. There are some examples for my. Você me cambia, hein? Sim, bota a pena.
É. Ok.
This is, there was some problem, because this is a paper with my colleagues in Lisbon, Aurelio Araújo and Cristóbal Mota Suárez. They are at the Institute Technical University of Lisbon. Then there is a identification of mechanical constants. Of mechanical constants of materials using a free vibration test. Then we have a plate. This is a plate, a composite plate. We make a free vibration test and we compute these eigenfrequencies with a finite element model. Then we define the objective function, we define physical constraints, and here with this objective function, we want to minimize the objective function, and when this objective function is zero, then we obtain the parameters. These are the elastic parameters. This is the, it shows the laboratory, the test, and then we have the numerical results, piezoelectric, elastic and piezoelectric properties. And here we have, no, I think, okay. Okay, thank you very much.